Hi, this is Elliot Eisenberg of Graphs and Laughs here to catch you up to date on the latest in residential sales data for Hillsborough County. And home price appreciation continues to be pretty strong in the 5 to 10% range for single fam and about the 15% range for multifam. And while these prices aren't as fast growing as they were a year ago, remember a year ago there was Omicron and it was one of the peak selling seasons in the entire COVID experience. If we continue now and look at closed sales, they're down about 25% for single fam and about 35% for multifam, a sign of a weakening market a little bit. And if we look at the sales price as a function of the original listing price, it's down by about 5 percentage points for both single fam and for multifam. And if we turn our attention and now look at new listings and pending sales, they're also down by about 10% for single and multifamily. Last but not least, inventories up by hundreds of percent, 200 to 300%, but only because the inventories were excruciatingly low a year ago when demand was astounding. This market is cooling, but prices continue to rise. And Pasco County is cooling like most other counties in the country, but doing remarkably well nonetheless. Single fam home price up about 5% year over year. Multifam is up technically about 40 or 50%, but only because last January was a ridiculously low price. If you exclude that issue, it's still up 20 or 25%, quite a lot. That said, closed sales are down about 20% on the single fam side and 35% on the multifam side. And the sales price as a percentage of the original listing price is down by 4 percentage points on both the single fam and the multifam side. So clear cooling. That said, if you look at pending sales and new listings, while they're both down on the single fam side, they're both up on the multifam side. So the multifam price appreciation's better, pending sales are doing better, more inventory. I think that's a little bit stronger sector. Last but not least, inventory. It's up about 200 or 250% year over year, but only because a year ago, because of Omicron, inventories were incredibly small and inventories remain very limited, even with this huge percentage increase. And Pinellas County, like many other counties, is slowing a little bit. Single fam home price appreciation, 2 to 3% ballpark figure. It's a little higher, 10% on the multifam side, probably because those properties are less expensive. If you look at sales activity, closed sales, it's down 40% in both the single fam side and the multifam side, clearly a sign of weakening. And if you look at sales price as a function of list price, it's down from 100% a year ago to 94% on the single fam side and 95% on the multifam side. So they're both also weakening there. If we look at pending sales activity, down 20% on single fam and 25% on multifam, again, a sign of weakening. And if you look at inventories, yes, I know they're up hundreds of percent, 250%, but don't let that deceive you. Inventories only up by that much because a year ago, because of COVID, inventories were magnificently tiny. And even with this huge increase, they're still well lower than they should be. While the first half of 2022 was pretty lousy with negative GDP growth in both Q1 and Q2, the second half of 22 was good with positive growth in both Q3 and Q4. And that positive momentum is carried on into this year. Q1 GDP growth is going to be pretty strong at least 2%. Unfortunately, that's unsustainably fast. Unemployment is actually declining and in January fell to 3.4, a 53-year low in unemployment. Moreover, because of the fast, relatively fast growth and good GDP number, unemployment, which the Fed desperately wants to quash and bring down to 2%, which is now at about 6, is falling too slowly. This combination of unemployment that's too low and inflation that's too high and falling too slowly is giving the Fed a heart attack. And the Fed has been told us now in very clear terms that they are going to be raising rates for the foreseeable future. They're going to raise rates in March. The next meeting is in May. They're going to raise rates in May. And they're also going to raise rates in June, their next meeting. They meet every 6 weeks. So there's 3/4 of a point of short-term interest rate hikes in front of us. The Fed desperately needs to slow this economy down and get inflation down. Remember, the Fed was late to the rate hiking cycle. They don't want to make a mistake and now stop raising rates too slowly. So they are going to continue to raise rates through June. At that point, they'll pause and take stock of what's going on. And hopefully in early 24, they'll start to lower rates. The upshot for the housing market of all this is that the nice, pleasant decline in interest rates that we experienced in the months of November, December, and January is history. In February, interest rates made a U-turn and they're rising again. I suspect that this will be a short-term process that ends in a couple of months, but nonetheless, it's causing heartache currently. We know that when the Fed raises rates, it takes 12 to 18 months for the full effect to be felt, and the bulk of the interest rate hikes didn't really begin until June of last year. So I expect the second half of the year to exhibit substantially slower economic growth and lower interest rates, and we will get there, but we're not there now, and rates have risen, unfortunately, in the last month or so. But I expect things to dramatically slow down in the second half of 2023. Be prepared. That's it for now, and I look forward to seeing you next month.